Let's get activated, let's get activated. Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. When the kick off the bum, run it back.
Home.
Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pack.
Whoa.
Familiar with the struggle, look, I'm coming up from scratch.
Nothing.
Huddle with my pain, then I turned it to some rats.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gon' tackle your little man.
Get them.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. Go.
The coach here, and welcome to this ultimate challenge. Sit back and relax. You're in for a real treat with this matchup. Let's get back to Brandon and Charles for the call.
We start this challenge in the third quarter, and there's still quite a bit of time left. You're ahead by just a field goal. Your opponent has the ball at midfield, and it's first down. Midfield now, here's Taylor. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Leonard Floyd, the old Georgia Bulldog, finding his way into the backfield. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure it out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back
under pressure, and they got to him again. Leonard Floyd able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Now Taylor, finding a safety valve here. That's complete. 14 yards, but they're still well shy of the first as that leads to fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back, but how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And just like that, another ultimate challenge has been defeated. Savor the victory, if only for a moment, because you know there's always another challenge right around the corner.
Hello, and welcome into this Madden Ultimate Team Showdown. I'm your host, the coach. Let's send it down to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis for the call.
Thanks, coach. We start this challenge in the third quarter, and there's still quite a bit of time left. We're all tied up 13 apiece. Your opponent has the football on their own 45-yard line. First and 10. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down. On second down, it's Wade. And the Buccaneer defense for the second straight play, flexing its muscle by forcing a loss. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. Out of the gun, it's Taylor. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. It was Von Miller who shot in there to get him down. And on now is the punter. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Averaging over 50 yards of punt so far as this one's away. And Sanders now to return. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Nicely done. Another one up, another one down.
Talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That chicken, he talking big hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they louder, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be couching, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the thousand, boy. They get you touch, and they get you fouled, boy. I'm talking, you out of bounds, boy. They always screaming, Rich be snapping. I say the collar, boy. I'ma lose the roof and the stain. Please don't test me like on that, boy, Johnny. And ain't talking dang. It's like everything look cut them jaw. They go insane, they want a pitch. Ain't gon' get in the beef. I'ma just make them blitz. Round four deep in the sprinter. How that's your girl, and she in my rental. We got cables, we ain't even have.
Hello there, it's the coach with you here today, and this is an Ultimate Challenge. Now let's hand it off to Brandon and Charles as we jump straight into the action.
We start this challenge in the third quarter, and there's still quite a bit of time left. You're only down 3 points. You have the ball on your own 20-yard line. As we get set here, first and 10. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's third and 10.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down. The offense is going to stay out there. They've converted twice, failed once so far on fourth down. Let's see what's in store here. That's caught by Waller out left side. Okay, so you won't be going undefeated against this challenge, but hey, the good news. And the offense readies for a first down and 10. Here's Namath. And Waller taking it in over the middle. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
3 yards the gain there, second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And that's going to lead to a third and 11. To throw is Namath. He'll dump this to Bo. It's complete. And he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a fourth down. Throwing is Namath. He'll find his tight end. That's Waller. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. Not quite enough that time. Maybe just try a lower start. So a first and 10 as the Buccaneer offense gets ready to go. Here's Namath. That's complete to his tight end, Waller. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back, and he'll be brought down right at the 30 here.
but they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Now Namath to throw. That's caught by Jackson. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It'll be a loss of 2, maybe 3 on the play. And that's going to lead to a third down. Namath now from the gun. A short one here secured by the tight end Waller. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
He's going to fire one deep over the middle, and it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively, and it'll bring up second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. To throw, Namath. And he'll look downfield for Waller. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have him looking at 3rd and 10. And he'll look downfield for Waller. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down. The 3 straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on 4. Now Namath. Escaping the pressure right. And going deep for Hill. And incomplete on the deep ball. Well, you came up short in this one, but... And now the offense getting set. 1st and 10. Namath to throw. Short throw going to be caught by Waller. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Continuing to steadily move the ball down the field. Not big play after big play, but these moderate gains getting him first downs.
And you know what they add up to, right? If you continue that pace and you continue to move it downfield, they add up into 6 points. That's exactly what you're looking for.
So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it'll be 2nd down. From the gun is Namath. Right side caught by Jackson.
That was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that? 2nd and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Did not get the snap away in time. Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. 1st and 15. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Powers through him. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it a 2nd down. Set up to throw. He'll hit Jackson complete. He can't get him down. He won't go down. And he's got room. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds.